I talked in the last video about the three different areas of your life in which you can create goals, and also how spirituality or religion fits into all three areas. Now I'm going to talk about how to choose which goals you are going to work on for the near future, okay? All three areas are very important, okay? And what I've learned in the past is whatever area is lacking is going to be your biggest pain point, okay? Whatever area of your life you are lacking in is going to be the part that slows you down, that keeps you from being as happy as you could be at that particular point, okay? So don't fall into the trap of thinking, I need to make, you know, material goals, I need to make physical goals, I need to make relationship goals. Don't go ahead and think you have to do everything at the same time, because there are different situations. If you're doing well in all three areas of your life, you can just say, listen, I just want to bump up, you know, my physical health by, you know, getting a little bit leaner, okay, getting a little stronger, whatever. Now I'm going to bump up, you know, my relationship goals by, you know, hanging out with, you know, the guys and playing golf once a week. And I want to go for a walk with my wife and my kids, you know, for like an hour or two once a week. Okay. You know, maybe, you know, you say, hey, listen, I've always thought about, you know, whatever, writing a book, or, you know, I need to start saving some more money or whatever, or paying the mortgage off faster or whatever. So I'm gonna make double payments on the mortgage. I mean, that's fine. And that means basically that all three areas of your life are in the same level. You're happy because all three areas are balanced out, okay? So it's okay to make a small goal in each of the three areas of your life and to keep up with it, because first of all, you're not gonna get discouraged, you're doing well as it is, and second, they're small goals. You know, just, you know, pay a little bit more on your mortgage. You know, just 1 hour with your friends playing golf, 1 hour with your kids and your wife. You know, just go ahead and just, you know, increase your number of pull-ups this year, whatever. You know, it's small goals if you're doing well. A lot of people aren't doing well, okay? A lot of people are out of whack. So the first thing you really want to do, in my opinion, is make sure that you reach this level where everything is on the same level, okay? Then you could just, like I said, just bump up everything slowly. It's easy, and there's no way you're really gonna fail doing that, okay? But let's say I'm making really good money, I get along with everybody, and I weigh 500 pounds. I am not fat bashing. I never fat bash. I do not fat bash. But the fact of the matter is, if you weigh 500 pounds, even if it were possibly 500 pounds of pure muscle, it's unhealthy to weigh that much. And nobody weighs 500 pounds of pure muscle. I mean, you know, we're talking about somebody that's at least 300 pounds overweight, 350 pounds overweight, and it's very unhealthy, okay? And that is like, maybe your money is good, maybe you get along with everybody, but you are way down, okay, in your physical space. So what I would suggest is you keep doing what you're doing, okay? People talk about spinning plates, like you have a little stick with a plate spinning on it, and then you do the next one. This one's already spinning. You just need to make sure it doesn't stop, and then you spin the next one. Then you go ahead and get the next one. You know, and you just start one at a time. It's the same thing here. Keep making money the way you are now, okay? Make sure that, you know, you do your job well, or keep your business or whatever it is you're making money, and your material life is going great. Make sure you keep up your relationships with all the people around you, okay? Great. But the thing that's slowing you down drastically is being that out of shape, okay? So that's what you really need to hit. You need to make some strong goals to get in shape. You know, you need to decide what the most important thing is. If you're 500 pounds, 350 pounds overweight, you really, really, really need to lose fat. You don't need to, you know, balance out a lagging body part. You don't need to go ahead and, you know, you need to lose fat. That's it, period, end of story. Okay, you really need to lose fat. And that will be the best thing that you can do. So what you do now is you make a very extensive set of goals for how you're going to get yourself in shape, okay, and lose fat. And then when you slowly come up to, you're in good shape. You're not ripped, you're not huge, but you're in good shape. You're average, maybe, you know, a little bit overweight, but you're not, you know, 350 pounds overweight. Now you're almost at the same level, making good money, good relationships, and you're in pretty good shape. So now you bump all three up at the same time. But if you're lacking physically, like I said, you really need to get on it this year. Now, let's see. There's a guy, I want to say he is in France. I think he spoke French. It could be anywhere from Canada to Belgium to Africa, for all I know. But, I think he spoke French, and I've seen him a couple times on YouTube. He is a homeless bodybuilder, okay? This guy is in incredible physical condition, does, like, incredible calisthenics and stuff. And he's living on the street, literally, okay? Now, he seems to be, he's obviously physically in very good shape. He seems to be, happy. He seems like when he talks to people, he seems to have a good relationship with people, but he's living on the damn street. I mean, period, end of story. I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that, anything bad about that, but the fact is he's in a different place. He's peak physical condition, gets along with everybody in terms of relationships, but he's broke. He lives on the damn street. So he needs to go ahead and concentrate on getting himself up to the same level. Let's say he gets to making a decent income, making, pretty good middle class kind of income, okay? And he's in awesome physical condition and gets along with every person he meets. Now he just needs to bump everything up, like I said. And of course, the same thing with relationships. Now let me say something about relationships. I talked in my last video that relationship goals, the very first most important thing is your relationship to yourself. If I'm not happy with myself, and if I don't like myself, I can't like a woman, I can't have a woman like me, it's not going to happen. You need to love yourself for somebody else to love you. Okay, so you're really hurting the people around you. And the problem with this is, it's like tearing off a Band-Aid, going to the dentist, it's like a lot of things where you have to go through something that sucks to get to something that's better. Now, what I'm talking about is this. You are not happy because you want to start a business. You are not happy because you want to get out of the army, join the army, get a different job, drop out of school, go back to school, whatever it is you want to do that your heart tells you, that you know what you want, okay? But your family, whether it's your wife that's nagging all the time or doesn't want you to do something, or wants you to continue doing something, whether it's, your family, like your parents or whatever, or your friends telling you not to do something, you might have to cut them out. And that's the weird thing. Like, to improve your relationships, you might have to end the relationship. You might have to say, I'm going to do this business and I'm not going to talk to my mother for the next 6 months. Come hell or high water, unless there's like a family emergency, I'm not going to talk to my mother for 6 months. So she has no influence on me. Now, working on this business, guess what? It's all on you. If you succeed, you succeeded. If you fail, you failed. If you don't take action, you didn't take action. But you at least can't blame it on your mother. The same thing with, with your wife. I mean, I remember there's a guy, Dean Graziosi. He wrote a really good book about, real estate investment, and he talked a lot about mindset in the book, believe it or not, okay? And because mindset is more important than information, technical abilities, technical information, mindset is much more important. Like, having the ability to know what you want, go after it 100% and not be afraid is more important towards getting in shape than knowing about diet and exercise. There are a lot of out-of-shape people who know about diet and exercise. But if you know what you want to do physically, and you will do it, part of that is finding out the information along the way. It also explains why there are so many MBAs, so many Harvard professors that don't have shit. I mean, they got a good job, maybe, but they don't really have shit. They never accomplished anything. And then you got like high school dropouts that create huge businesses, make millions upon millions of dollars because they don't have the knowledge of how to do something technically, but they have the ability to motivate themselves, to motivate others, to pick up the knowledge, to get people working for them who know what to do. So like I said, mindset's very important, and it was a large part of this book on real estate investment. Getting back to relationships, one of the things he said was, he doesn't want to tell you to get a divorce, but one of the guys in like his mastermind group or went to his seminars would go out and drive around looking for properties, to invest in. And his wife was always nagging and like, wow, this stupid dream, and why do you even want to do this? And we don't even have the money to do this, and da 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 da, and you're wasting another weekend driving around looking for properties. He ended up getting a divorce from her. He ended up meeting a woman who was also very interested in investing in real estate, and they had like their own house plus like five others. It was some story like that. They had several rental properties and their own house, okay? So like I said, it's really kind of a hard thing here, but sometimes when you have a relationship goal, you might have to put somebody on hiatus. You might have to say, listen, I'm going to have a 3-month trial separation from my wife or, you know, my girlfriend or whatever, and work on yourself. You might have to say you're not going to talk to your family. You might have to say you're not going to hang out in a bar with your friends anymore. And like I said, and doing that will make you happy with yourself. Because once again, if you don't love yourself, if you don't get along with yourself, you're not going to love anybody else. You're not going to get along with anybody else, and nobody else is going to love you or get along with you. So you might have to take a hiatus or cut off, you know, contact completely to go ahead and love yourself. That's the most important thing. And believe me, I know this from experience. If you say, listen, I'm not going to talk to my family, or I'm going to break up with, you know, a girl, or put the relationship on hiatus or whatever, and then you go ahead and achieve your goal, everybody's going to act like they were behind you 100%. Like, oh yeah, you know, your family was trying to drag you down, keep you from doing something because either A, they tried to do a business before and failed, you know, And maybe they're afraid, like, I don't want you to go through the pain, which is noble. They don't want you to go through the pain of failing at a business and losing your ass. On the other hand, a lot of times, and I think it's more often, people, you know, are scared, like, I lost my ass doing a business, and because of that, I'm going to look like an idiot if you succeed, so I don't want you to succeed. And yet another way to look at this whole situation is people just can't possibly understand it. Like, how is somebody going to pay you to, you know, do whatever, you know? It's like, well, you know, it happens, okay? They just can't fathom the concept. It's not like they're trying to discourage you or protect you. It's just they don't understand what you're even trying to do. So like I said, that's the hard thing about setting relationship goals. You know, it's easy to say, I'm going to go for a walk with my wife once a week, but it's hard to say, I'm going to have a trial separation from my wife for 3 months and to see if I can set this business up and how we get along when we're not around each other. So anyway, those are... that's how you decide what's the most important thing. You know, like I said, whatever's lagging is the thing that you need to improve the most. The more it's lagging behind, you know, like I said, you know, good money, good relationships, everybody likes you, but, you know, you're 350 pounds overweight, you need to hit that hard. And don't even think about relationships, don't even think about money. Just keep doing what you're doing at your job, you know, with your friends and family. Keep doing what you're doing. But definitely the only goal you need is the one where you're really severely lagging behind in. Now, in the next video, I'm going to talk about the two different ways that I have come up with to actually go ahead and achieve the goals that you have set.